Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Pitch Drop. I'm your host, Weird Beats, and today I'll be showing you how to do a pitch drop, aka turntable stop, aka tape stop. They're pretty much all the same thing. They sound like this. Alright, now that you got it. So in order to do a pitch drop, aka a turntable stop, we can get this nice little plugin on the Max for Live website called Pitch Drop. And it works pretty great if you're a moron. I found a few other ones that are much better. This one called Pitch Drop 1. It actually has the same exact name. I just named it Pitch Drop 1. This one's much better because it allows you to sync the timing of it as well. While the other one, as you can see, just you have to measure out the milliseconds, which is obviously a pain in the ass. Today I'll be showing you where you can get these two cooler devices and how we can use them. This version of the pitch drop actually comes with the Max for Live Essentials pack. If you have Ableton 10 Suite or higher, it comes with that. Or you can get the Max for Live Essentials pack off their website, but you have to have a registered copy of Ableton to be able to download it. I was definitely able to download it. I will also save and upload the device for my computer to make it easier for you guys to get this device, because I don't think you should have to download the whole Essentials pack just to get the pitch drop. So yeah, the link for that is down in the description. The way you use it is you put it on your master track or your vocals or anywhere you think it would sound cool. Just activate the drop. You probably want to use automation when you do it. That's how I usually do it. You can also program a button for it as well, whatever works for you. And you can change the duration of the drop here. And you can also change sharp or soft, which is a subtle change in the way the pitch drop acts. It's pretty obvious how it should work there. Sharp, soft. All right, one thing worth mentioning with this version of the plugin though, we're gonna call this one Pitch Drop 1.0. The original one is Pitch Drop. This one's Pitch Drop 1.0. If you change the drop duration to something besides 1/4, when you open your project again, it'll act as if it's at 1/4 again. So every time you open your project again, you're gonna wanna do this. You turn your knob once and turn it back to make it reset. Otherwise, it'll mess up the timing. I'll just show you guys what it does. So if you don't do this little trick that I just showed you guys, it'll sound like this when you meant it to sound like this. I feel like it's a bug definitely worth mentioning because I don't know, I didn't know it was there at first. And then once I figured it out, I was like, oh, okay. Well, it's kind of a dumb thing to keep happening. Okay, and there's also another one called Tape Stop 2.0. Essentially, it's the same thing as this pitch drop one, but it also allows you to do an up stop as well. Okay, wait, I know how to explain it. What I just said doesn't make sense, obviously. It allows you to do like a slow start as well once you stop it. So you change your settings, beats, maybe I'll put each one to one. How about that? What's different about this Tape Stop 2.0 version too as well is you need to hold it down when you do it. It's not an on or off button, it's like a button you need to hold down. I don't know how else to describe it. That slow up effect as well. You can only do that with this Tape Stop 2.0 device. Really hard to time this Tape Stop one, I find, when you're doing the up time. Another option is Gross Beat, which is actually a VST plugin. It comes from Fruity Loops, which I know, we promised not to talk about that. So Ableton Gang, just know you can also get Gross Beat as well, so we don't have to touch Fruity Loops. Ooh. Okay, that's it for this video. I'm your host, Weird Beats. I post videos on music production or just general music every Monday, Wednesday, Friday on YouTube, and I post music on SoundCloud every few weeks. I also post that on my YouTube and Spotify, yada yada. I stream music production on my YouTube as well every Friday. Yeah, sometimes I don't do it. And sometimes I'll sneak in one every other day or so, I don't know. So surprise streams here and there. What do you guys use for turntable or tape stops? Let me know down in the comments. Do you even do turntable or tape stops? I don't know. Press some of the buttons, you know the drill. Tune in next time when I meet Aphex Twin. Wait, seriously?